Okay, so we want to switch over to matters in Tanzania. Now, preparations for the Sunday election are in high gear as the country's coalition of opposition parties, UKAWA, has requested outgoing President Jakaya Mrisho Kikwete to make sure that Sunday's election is free and fair. The coalition has for some time been alleging that the ruling party, Chama Cha Mapinduzi, has plans of rigging the election. And now we want to speak to Francis Ontomwa, who together with our political editor, Ben Kitili, have been based in Tanzania for the last month, bringing us up to date with the issues that the Tanzanians want addressed in this election. Francis, thanks for joining us tonight. Just tell us what happens between now and election day.
Good evening, Yvonne. Yes, it's the home stretch here in Tanzania, and in the next few hours, it's a matter of counting down hours. Tanzanians will be knowing who their set of leaders will be. And it's an out-and-out approach for, it's a common strategy for top competitors, that is the Chama Cha Mapinduzi and the Umoja wa Katiba Wananchi Coalition. They are trying to lay a common kind of strategy. They are moving to major towns. Today, Lowassa, head of Lowassa was in Tanga. Major town here in Tanzania trying to move voters. Well, Magufuli has been pitching tent around the city of Dar es Salaam. We are expecting tomorrow to have even a bigger kind of approach, because Edward Lowassa will be doing a State of the Nation address. He'll be doing his laying the last minute approaches to voters. And we're expecting John Pombe Magufuli to be also holding a major rally at the historic Jangwani grounds here in Dar es Salaam. And we are headed to this poll. Of course, there is a controversy surrounding the opposition trying to lay claims of rigging, planned rigging by the National Elections Commission. But we have heard the National Elections Commission coming out clearly saying that these are just mere allegations and they are planned elections that will be conducted as in a free and fair kind of atmosphere. One.
A very close election, Francis. Even though the polls seem to put John Magufuli ahead, do you get a sense of, you know, voter optimism? You know, can we predict that voter turnout will be high, or what is the mood on the ground in Tanzania?
One, a study was conducted here by UKAWA East Africa, a non-governmental organization, and according to the study, they are saying out of 10 voters here in Tanzania, 9 have expressed the optimism of going out to vote. And when you talk to Tanzanians here on the streets in the capital city of Dar es Salaam, you get a feeling that indeed they are ready. Most of them are out and out more. Some of them saying that they want to change the administration and their ruling party, but others saying that they want to maintain the status quo. So it's a whole environment, or rather the atmosphere here is high, that many are expressing optimism that they'll be going for the democratic exercise of camp funding.
All right, Francis, thank you very much for that, reminding us of that poll, telling us that 9 out of 10 Tanzanians will have indicated that they will go to the polls, of course. Mbivu na mbichi atajulikana on Sunday. All right. So please do remember, by the way, that we will be covering this election in a way only we can. Francis Ontomwa, Ben Kitili, John Alanamu, Mohamed Ali is in Zanzibar as well. We will be covering this election for you up until the last vote is counted and the winner announced.